The RV Show USA is brought to you by Rockwood, building better RVs, making smarter RVers.
The RV Show USA.
And now, live from the RV Show USA studios in San Antonio, Texas, it's your RV and wingman, Alan Warren.
Hey folks, welcome back to the show. In this segment, you're going to find out what some RV manufacturers do not want you to know. Because if you knew it, you'd most likely not buy their brand. So what can you look for? What should you be looking for when you are RV shopping to make sure that you got the best built RV for you? We're going to give you some of the answers right now with my buddy Zach Reininger from the Flagstaff Rockwood Division of Forest River. So just a few minutes ago, we were talking about that quality is not always visible to the naked eye. Oftentimes it isn't. And some of the things that makes a quality RV versus the run-of-the-mill RV. Aluminum is something that I saw a lot of when I went to the Rockwood Flagstaff plant up there in Millersburg. A lot of aluminum instead of little one-by-one lumber. Talk to me about what you use all that aluminum framing for and why it's a benefit and much better than wood.
Sure. So we use aluminum for almost everything, frankly. And as far as I'm aware, we are the last brand that's still doing all sides aluminum. And by that, I mean roof, floor, walls, front and rear walls, all sides. Most other brands out there will say, put a sticker on something and say aluminum frame. Well, maybe on their side walls, but then they're using wood in the roof, wood in the floor, wood in the front and rear walls because it's cheaper, because they think a customer will never notice. And not that wood is bad. As an industry, we've been building with wood for over 100 years. But the benefit of aluminum is a couple fold. One, it's obviously lighter, so we can build a bigger floor plan with lighter weight. But it's also much more consistent. It's not an organic material. It is not. We're not relying on a consistency of trees across the board for it to be a perfect fit every time. We know what we're getting with aluminum time and time and time again. So it's consistent, which allows for us to have higher quality standards and a more consistent build quality for our customers.
And what about the flooring? Something as basic as flooring and just a little bit more that you spend on materials there at your plant can make years worth of difference in the pleasure and the ownership experience in the finished RV. Talk to me about that.
Sure. So, it's one of those things that I think with age comes wisdom, if you will, where, we've been around for almost 44 years now. And actually it was back in, I think, 1996, we started doing laminated floors. And the reason we did laminated floors was because at the time it was better for our customer because it was lighter weight and you could, show this greater insulation value, all this stuff. But over time we found that it's actually not the most superior way to build a floor. What we found is that to build a more structurally sound floor that's best for our customer is cost a little bit more money, but we come in and we use sheets of plywood decking that are tongue and groove. And this is all on an aluminum frame still. So it's still an aluminum frame. We don't use a wood frame floor. But then what we do is we come in and on every beam of our floor, we run a bead of adhesive, automotive adhesive on there. So we lay down, we glue, tongue and groove, then screw our floors down. So that's an extra labor step that we do. And again, this is something the customer would never know that we do this. But the reason we do that is it helps eliminate squeaks. It's as simple as that. There's nothing that'll drive a customer more insane than every time they walk by their kitchen island, the floor squeaks, and then they go get a quote to see how much it costs to fix that screw, and they find out it's $2,500 because they have to do a complete new lintel job.
And it's because all it took was just a little bit more at the plant when it was built and made the first time. So, but the flooring, going back to what the original, I guess it's OSB or particle board. Some manufacturers still use that for the flooring of their RV, and all you got to do is see what happens when that stuff gets wet, and it ain't pretty, folks. It ain't pretty.
It's with the OSB material, it's two things for them. One, it's consistent because it's one sheet of 24 foot long that they can just drop it right on there. It's easy for the plant. So it's easy for the production, but it's not the best for the customer. The other thing is, well, it's got a 10-year warranty on it. Well, if you've ever read the warranty, what it really is it's got to be an act of God that something happened to it. And then when it does, it's like, okay, you're right, it's covered. Here's your 24-foot section of OSB. Thank you for being a customer. Oh. So what the heck are you supposed to do with that? It doesn't pay to pull out all your cabinets and put that in there and redo your linoleum. It doesn't pay for any of that. It gets you 24-foot piece of OSB. So it's another one of those things that's a bit misleading to the customer where they think it's a 10-year warranty on the floor. Well, yeah, but then you got to fix it. So why don't you just do it right from the get-go?
Do it right the first time. You know, I put a pencil to it, and in my mind, I figured out that the difference, if it costs $300 to $500 more to make the marine grade 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood floor, $300 to $500 more, but you get years more use and value and quality out of your RV. But again, that's one of those things that the customer never sees, rarely thinks about, and that's why this education is so important. And we're going to move along with some other topics, but I got to tell you, I don't know of a single brand of anything. I don't care if it's a car, a watch, a RV, anything that has stood the test of time by being cheap. Quality does not equate with being cheap. Quality can be a value, and I think that we always have to provide a value for our customers. But cheap never stands the test of time, and it really doesn't stand the test of time with RVs.
You're so right. And one of our things that we talk about internally as far as how we create more value for our customers, and whether this is in our customer service department, and Carl Miller, who you've had on here before, he drives a lot of this. But one of our driving forces is making price irrelevant. We provide so much value by doing things the right way and high quality that it doesn't matter. And I'm not saying it needs to be ridiculous, but it removes that objective that, oh, I might go save $1,000 over here on this other product, but they don't realize everything that we've talked about that they don't have. And it's just not worth it. And I mean, all it takes is 3 months of that thing sitting in their service lineup before all that money you saved, quote, is chewed up in payments, insurance, and all that storage that you're not getting to use because it's sitting in a service lineup waiting for parts.
Yeah, and the RV won't last as long. I've got some friends that we've made friends with, this couple that comes up to our campground, and they've got a Flagstaff, and it's an older one. They bought a used one, but they absolutely love it. They had a newer brand X that they didn't care much for. They got a larger used Flagstaff, and they said it's awesome, and it's like 8 years old, so they love it, got a good deal on it, and they're very happy with it. So quality does matter. I think that when you buy cheap anything, that's kind of a recipe for short-term profits and problems for you, the consumer, down the road.
Absolutely, and it's funny you mentioned that because it's amazing how many customers we have that either bought one used and then come back and buy a Flagstaff new, or they've owned multiple Flagstaffs. And it's the highest form of flattery, in my opinion, to have our customers that are prior owners. They come to the shows. We get to meet them. They'll tell you, man, this is my third Flagstaff. We're going to buy this one. We've been waiting for you guys to do XYZ or this new slide room or whatever it might be. We're buying another one. We won't own anything else. And it's the biggest compliment that we could ever receive, and it is so cool. And we have customers that will come see us at a show just to come thank us for what we do and how we build our product. And they're our largest advocates out there.
When I was in the TV fishing show business, I had boat sponsors, and my boat sponsor was the Cadillac, if you will. It was the Flagstaff Rockwood of the marine industry. And people that didn't know, it's a pretty boat. There are a lot of pretty boats. But the people that knew, ooh, you've got a such and such. And that's what they're saying about the quality RVs. Oh, you got a Flagstaff. We're going to get one of them next time. So
I like to joke, too, about, you know, when I visit my dealerships out there, and I've got, 42 of them that I go visit, everybody at the dealership loves seeing us because they love our product. They love selling it. They have so much confidence in it. There's one group of people at a dealership that do not like us.
And that's Hang on. Don't say it. Don't say it because we have to wrap this segment up. We're going to do that on next week's show.
Okay.
So, Zach, you hold on.
I'll bite my tongue.
This has been really, really good. You know what I love so much about these segments is that we give you things to look for, specific things to look for when shopping for that new RV. Important things. I hope you're enjoying these segments as much as I am. If you have a question you'd like me to ask the manufacturer, a topic that you'd like to hear discussed here on the show, call, leave us a voicemail 24/7. You should know the number by now. 1-330-WINGMAN. 1-330-WINGMAN.